Hey everybody, welcome to UGASports. We're going to go through our galleries for the last few days. We'll start off there with Isaiah Wilson, working through, hitting Warren McClendon, working his way up to the next level. Kind of knocked the sweat off McClendon there. You kind of see it flying through the air a little bit. I imagine if he hit me, it'd knock the sweat off me too. Warren will be fine, he'll shake his head a little bit and turn around and do the exact same thing to Isaiah. So that's how they roll. Good to see that Dominic Blaylock was back at practice. I know there have been some questions about whether or not he was out there. That was him at number 8. Big Solomon McKinley giving you that look like, yeah, don't put me on the All-American SEC, All-SEC roster. I'll show you what I can do. Justin Schaefer, number 54. A lot of people forget about that he's out there, but he is. And that's Xavier Truss, who's looking very good for a freshman who was much bigger than that when we saw him in Atlanta. Back to Isaiah Wilson. Why is he wearing long sleeve sweatshirt or whatever, but then has it, but not over his belly? Anybody that wears long sleeves under their shoulder pads is a psychotic man. That's all there is to it. I mean, he's just a psycho. Speaking of psychos, we have Cade Mays, one of the toughest guys on the team, pound for pound. One of the meanest guys that will throw you around. Big tattoo there, I wonder what it said. Owen Condon out there, young guy, working at left tackle behind Andrew Thomas. If I had to look at Andrew Thomas every day, I'd give him a little side eye too. Big Ben Cleveland. Oh my God, that guy's a monster. When I put him at 3-2-1, I will not have him as the starter at right guard. Yeah, don't know about that. Stetson Bennett, everybody's favorite backup quarterback. Definitely favorite of the team. Trey Hill, number 55, number one in your hearts, your center. Guy's going to do well this year. Juan Mathis out there, skinny guy, very skinny. Brian Herrien, I know a lot of people are wondering how he's going to do. I think Brian has, what the hell is that? What's mustache there, Jake Frohn? Yeah, DeAndre Swift's looking at him like, what the hell? Is he scared of it? I'd be scared of it. Yeah, he's going to pretend like he didn't see anything. Yeah, I'm just going to stand over here. You give me the ball. Don't. Even Brian Herrien is like, what the hell is that? So he's got everybody's attention. Of course, if I was Brian Herrien, I would walk around with a shirt on all the time. Little handoff here. We're going to see this a lot. You know, the play action. You got to bring them in. Worst case scenario, if any quarterback you put out there, just do this. Here, hand the ball to DeAndre Swift. And behind that offensive line, it's going to get going. If DeAndre Swift's not available, hand it to this guy. Hand it to Zamir White. See what he can do. Or Brian Herrien, as we mentioned before. Zamir, he looks good out there, folks. I mean, I'm not trying to build up the hype about him. I think he's going to be more like Nick Chubb after his return. I don't think he's going to, you know, he's not Nick Chubb as Nick Chubb was his senior year. He's going to be that recovery year. But if that's true, then don't forget about James Cook. Number 4. Five-star guy, 4 on your roster. Back to Mathis, don't think he's ready to play yet. He's not been cleared, but we've got our fingers crossed for him. Back to James Cook, just do not count him out. James Coley, the offensive coordinator, has a lot of weapons, and James Cook is definitely one of them. Jess Sutherland, California, keep an eye on him. They brought him in for a reason. He thinks he can win a scholarship. John Sutter, another backup quarterback. You got to love what Sutter's doing. If it wasn't for him, you wouldn't be able to run all these practices. You got to have guys like that. Here's the mustache rolling out. Expect to see a lot of that. I wonder if he'll have that for Vandy. I wonder if he'll just be that distracting for the outside linebackers. This guy will be distracting for the outside linebackers for sure, DeAndre Swift. Or not take pictures of when he's out there. Oh, this was dumb. They were running these little drills and they weren't separated far enough and these two guys run into each other. Not badly, but it was just not separated like it should have been. Here's your wide receiver crew. When they come walking across the field, I kept wanting to hear the Right Stuff music playing, you know, from the movie The Right Stuff. See, that's what I'm saying. It's just, you can kind of hear it in the background. The unsung heroes, the guys everyone who doubted. 83 is big George Pickens. 16 is Demetrius Robertson. Demetrius isn't a small guy, but it just shows you how big George Pickens is. Who is that, Cade Mays again? Ooh, see, when Saul McKinley hits you, you got hit. Sweat flying again. He's popping in pads. Andrew Thomas. I mean, it was a fun 3 years, Andrew. Or at least should be by the time this is over. Owen Condon, you just can't coach that size, folks. I know a lot of people aren't, you know, looking at this incoming freshman. Don't forget about Owen Condon. Aziz Ojulari, speaking of a guy that everyone kind of forgot about right off the bat. Aziz is working as a starter behind him. Here in number 11, you have Jermaine Johnson. Jermaine's been a little beat up in the startup camp. So right now, I think he's running with the twos. Getting a lot of coaching there from Dan Lanning. Nine right here. That is, I believe, Adam Anderson wearing a scout team jersey. And the long sleeve black in the 95 degree heat. Yeah, better him than me. You see Walter Grant up there, 84. Aziz Ojulari, 13. Nolan Smith and Jermaine Johnson, 11 and 4. Respectively, out there doing their things. That was Aziz you saw right before that. Here's Walter Grant. They have to hit the dummy, pop it up, and then they go and wrap up. How would you like to be the GA who gets to stand there and get picked up? Look how long Walter Grant's arms are. Just go around and meet him. Jermaine Johnson, great base on the kid, huge thighs. He's able to get hit and deliver a blow, and then he goes and wraps up. So when he jams that tackle or tight end's going to stay jammed. Nolan Smith, when Marlo Herrera saying, what jersey get? I'm like, get a Nolan Smith jersey. Get a number 4, because this kid is going to be lights out. He had to do a second rep here. Dan Lanning wanted to do it again, and it just shows when he hits that thing. Again, his form wasn't right, so Dan Lanning made him do it again. But once he gets his form right, this kid is going to be a monster. Adam Anderson again, knocking the poor GA back. Just really not fair there. See, arms too. These arms aren't quite as long, so it's not fair. I don't know who that is. Who's that off the top of my head? Nice catch. It wasn't Mark Webb. So we're getting into some of the scout team jerseys. It makes it a little bit tougher to figure out who's who. You got Dominic Blaylock, I believe. Made money on it. Hey, N'Kobe Dean, 17, the guy who was out, you know, he missed a practice and everyone was freaking out. And we said, look, it's got a minor ankle sprain. He's going to be fine. And he's back out of practice. 14, DJ Daniel. DJ repping with the ones, repping with the twos. Not quite sure where he's going to be. I should have some news on him soon. Getting that finger fixed. Nothing like having a nice jam on one of your fingers. That's always fun. Eric Stokes, 27, your starting cornerback. Some guy who used to play at Georgia back in the day. Who can still sling the ball around a little bit. I see you, Kirby Smart. DJ Daniel and Eric Stokes working together, 14 and 27 respectively. Keep an eye on those two guys. One of your scout team guys, if I'm not mistaken. Guys on the scout team, not sure who that was. Yeah, you actually see right there, N'Kobe Dean taking the hit. Anyway, that's all the time we got. Y'all take care.